गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास। स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो व्हेन वी गो थ्रू वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ मेल गैमेट ओवोफाइट वाज डिस्कस्ड। ऑन द कंटिन्यूएशन वी स्टार्ट टुडे विद the female reproductive part of a flower called gynoecium. Gynoecium represents the male reproductive part of the flower. The word gynoecium represents one or more pistils of a flower. The word pistil, which refers to the ovary, style and stigma. A pistil is derived from a carpel. The word ovary represents that part which contains the ovule. Stigma, which serves as a landing platform for pollen grains. The style is an elongated slender part which is beneath the stigma. The basal swollen part of the pistil is the ovary, which you can see in this picture. Ovules are present inside the ovary cavity called a ligule on placenta. Gynoecium or carpel, which arises a small papillate outgrowth of meristematic tissue from the growing tip of the floral primordium. It grows very actively and soon gets differentiated into ovary, style, stigma. The ovules or megasporangia arises from the placenta. The megasporangia or ovule arises from the placenta. The number of ovules in an ovary may be one, example paddy, wheat and mango, or many, example papaya, watermelon and orchids. Let us continue with structure of ovule, megasporangium. Structure of ovule or megasporangium. Mega, large, sporangium, larger gamete or larger cell producing structure. Microspores are produced within the anther cavity. Megaspores are produced or ovule produced within the ovary cavity. Ovule is called megasporangium. Each megasporangium, if you observe, it is protected by integuments. Ovule is called megasporangium and it is protected by integuments. Integuments may be one or two coverings. And mature ovule consists of a stalk. Mature ovule, which consists of a stalk and a body. The stalk is also called as funiculus, is present at the base and it is attached the ovule to the placenta. I'm repeating, the stalk or funiculus is present at the base of the ovule, is attaches the ovule to the placenta, which you can see over here. The point of the attachment of funicle to the body of ovule is known as hilum. The point of attachment of funicle to the body of the ovule is called hilum. It represents the junction between the ovary and the funicle. Generally, ovule is an inverter. The funicle is adnate to the body of the ovule. Adnate means closer. And forming a ridge called raphe. The body of the ovule is forming. The body of the ovule is made up of central mass of parenchymatous tissue called nucellus, which serves the reserve food material . The nucellus is developed by one or two protective coverings called integuments. Integuments which encloses the nucellus completely except at the top, which you can see. The top is called the chalazal end. Opposite the chalazal end, you can see the micropyle. In the top, where the integuments is free and forms a pore called as micropyle. An ovule may have one or two integuments. If one integument, it is called unitegmic. If it is two integuments, it is called bitegmic ovule. The basal region of the body of the ovule where the nucellus, the integument and the funicle meet or merge is called chalaza. So the basal region of the body of the ovule, such as nucellus, integuments and the funicle, or meet or merge together called chalaza. Chalaza you can see on the top. There is a large oval sac-like structure in the nucellus towards a micropyle is called as what? Embryo sac is also called as female gametophyte. It develops as It develops and forms a functional megaspore within the nucleus. In some species, unitegmic 10 uninucellate, where the inner layer of the integuments may become specialized to perform nutritive function. For the embryo is called endothelium or integumentary tapetum. I'm repeating, in some species, the inner layer of the integument become specialized to perform nutritive function. For the embryo is called as endothelium or integumentary tapetum, which is commonly seen in the family called Asteraceae. There are two types of ovules. Based on the position of the sporogenous cell. If the sporogenous cell is hypodermal with a single layer of nucellar tissue around it is called as 10 uninucleate type. Normally, 10 uninucleate ovules have very small nucellus. Ovules with the subhypodermal sporogenous tissue is called crassi nucellate type. So there are two types of ovule based on the position of the sporogenous cell. The first one is called tenui nucellate type. As I told earlier, if the sporogenous cells is hypodermal with a single layer of nucellar tissue around it is called as tenui nucellate type. Normally these type of ovules have very small nucellus. Crassi nucellate type, ovules which are hypodermal, ovules with the subhypodermal sporogenous cells is called crassi nucellate type. This type of ovules have fairly large nucellus. The next is hypostae and epistae. Children, now you can see the two types of ovule based on the position of sporogenous tissue. One is tenui nucellate and crassi nucellate. Group of cells which found at the base of the ovule between the chalaza and embryo sac is called hypostae. A group of cells which found at the base of the ovule between the chalaza and embryo sac is called hypostae. Hypostae is very clearly visible. And the next one, epistae. It is thick-walled cells found above the micropylar end above the embryo sac is called epistae. In this picture where epistae and hypostae is visible. Dear children, in this video, the structure of embryo sac was explained. In this video, you might understand about the structure of ovule in detail along with the nature of the sporogenous tissue. Based on its position, how the ovules are divided into two types. Go through the video. Thank you.